industry has done a lot of work trying to incentivize people to come home. But at the end of the day, really, it's a question of incentives. Many people, I fully agree with you, Sheila, because I remember even, not just in, even incentives, but disincentives. I had a friend who was trained as a doctor, but he said, I mean, he loves the country so much. He's the son of a constitutional convention, one of our foremost constitutionalists who passed on, Jose Noriedo. He was my classmate in high school, and he was telling me, you know that for me too, I'm already a trained doctor in a particular, very specific field, but for me to go home and practice, I need to undergo another set of tests. Yeah. I'm already trained in the U.S. So, you have these barriers already. I mean, originally, I mean, I can understand that all of these things were developed. They were to prevent people who are not that good to, you know. But then things are changing, and then, you know, the rules take a life of their own. So, unfortunately, I think what we need to do now is start looking at all of even doing an inventory of sorts of all the regulatory frameworks we have across the country. I'm sure we're doing it in, you know, little by little, but it's not systematically done. I remember I was very glad that Dr. Yanto started that regulatory piece last year, no, for the, because I think regulations, you know, are there because they are trying to promote us to have some welfare for the community. But unfortunately, sometimes, as I said, they tend to be, yeah, they tend to put more barriers to improving that. So that's one, as far as skill diasporas are concerned, there's so much. So some people, Dado Banatao, big name, when he came, he's already too big that, I guess, he was too big to ignore. So sometimes some Filipinos, they come, they do well in other countries, and when they come back, that's the only time we listen to them. But I feel if, you know, 10, 20 years ago, we could have asked these guys to come back. We didn't, partly because there were too many people who were putting all of these barriers. And even until now, even you say, yeah, balik scientist program, we also have it now, I think, as another package in the USP. I often wonder to what extent all of those incentives will really be ways for us to help people connect. And by incentivizing them, indeed I agree with Sheila that, do you really need to make them come home for good? Or don't you, being in an era of globalization, they can still do their work there, but if their heart is still here and they're going to do work with us, why not? Isn't it? All these barriers are already starting to disappear because of technology. We're in a much global village now. So, but the only thing is, of course, that assumes you have good internet. No? The ICT, of course, I know it's working on it, but then, you know what? But it's, there's so many things that are contingent on, and I feel so bad because sometimes when I work in other countries, I go to other countries, even for whatever, you know, just go to the airport of other countries and compare the Wi-Fi that you get in our own airport, right? You feel saddened because that small story about Wi-Fi speed is already showing us it's a microcosm of what's going on in the innovation ecosystem. That some establishments have put their foot way ahead of others and they're not letting others to come in. And then you also have this issue about government for a long time not also thinking ahead, putting its own, I mean, on one level, we did try to have the national broadband before, but it had its problems. We all know the stories, but still, there could have been other ways for us to sit down and talk, but we don't. I mean, if we talk, we keep talking and talking and talking, and no action. And that's the reason why Filipinos got fed up and said, yeah, last year, voted out somebody else who doesn't seem to be, you know, it's a bit different, you know, from the rest. People are irritated that the changes are, I mean, even now, di ba, pupunta niyo dito, she tried the MRT, kahapon lang yata, pumaan yung MRT, di ba, nung usok. It's sad because the thing is, you know that there are all these human potentials. There are a lot of human, there are a lot of good people we have, but why is it things are not working? You know, we have to keep. We really have to have a real plan. On one hand, this whole point also mentioned by Sheila about the linkages. Filipinovation was meant to be a mechanism by which you put people together from industry. But my only sense was that BOST has had been doing just working with very little budgets. So if the reality is, if you want to make big changes, you have the big budgets, but which BOST never had, you know. I also remember Dublin Padiranga. Sorry, but Dublin had so many ideas even about science. He also was wondering, should BOST even be a department, or should it be focused on funding just like in other countries, the National Science Foundation, big money, give them big money, and then they craft where to put the money on R&D. Because even me, I remember when I took PhD, I was supported by my advisor who had a grant from the Navy, the U.S. Navy, Office of Naval Research, to do, imagine, Naval Research, U.S. Office of Naval Research, to do work on reliability of equipment that we were getting data from AT&T Bell Laboratories. See what I mean? But DOST is working with little budgets, and then we have RDIs meeting, they're also competing for resources. So I also wonder, should RDIs be there? Because sometimes you don't know whether, because it seems like DOST has had a role to play as a champion of sorts, but at the same time, it was also being asked to deliver products. Just like so one wonders whether our mandates in government are confused and whether we need to rethink our organizational structures. Even now with the ICP, you have LDFRB under you, right? Attached? Oh no, I'm sorry. Department of Transportation. The ICP, sino ba yung nasa inyo?
NCC,
NCC. Then yung Privacy Commission. National Privacy Commission, fine, you know. But NPC, okay. But you wonder what is, parang we really need to rethink this whole concept of being a regulator, being a service delivery. Because eventually you'll be monitoring yourself also. It's just hard, eh? So unless you have very clear mandates that are distinct, I think. That also can be a potential to that's why even here at PIDS we have been working on independent research, trying to do independent research. So even us, we also do things depending on budgets. So much as we would like to do many things, but we also are constrained by our own budgets. But anyways. My point being, again, going back to the USD and other agencies, we need to even go back to our own mandates and ask whether we need to do re-engineering, especially in the wake of all of these attempts to resize government bureaucracy. Should certain institutions like RDI, should they be under you or should they be under in universities directly?
Or privatized.
Privatized, oh, maybe. So many things. Sorry, marami pa. But then, let me just give the floor to my other, and just to answer the other questions. I might